Hello and welcome to this next part of digital communication series. So in this part, we are going to discuss scrambling. So first we'll discuss what is scrambling, why it is required. Then we'll discuss the scrambler, transmitter or descrambler or the receiver. So we'll discuss the full circuit, how we can rearrange the data through scrambling, and then we'll discuss an example based upon scrambling. So first thing in your mind would be, what is scrambling? Scrambling is the rearrangement of digital data. So if I have some digital data in the form of, So this was my digital data, I can rearrange it in the form of, so this data and this data contains equal zeros and equal ones, but only the thing is, this is the rearranged version of this data. So scrambling is basically the rearrangement of digital data. Now the second thing in your mind would be, why at all scrambling is required? So why scrambling? The first answer to this question is for data security. So let's see how we can secure our data using scrambling. So we can avoid unauthorized access of our data. What does it mean? So if my original data was this and my rearranged data was this, so this was the data which was thrown into the space to reach to the receiver. So if any other receiver receives this data, he'll not be able to decode that actually the data was this, it was not this. So the another receiver would only receive this data and he'll not be able to rearrange the actual data. So this is how we'll avoid the unauthorized access of our data, and it will provide us data security. The next thing would be the timing extraction. So let's see how it will give me the timing extraction. So if I have long series of zeros and ones, my receiver won't be able to know if a long series of zero is coming, that the data is coming. Actually, it will think that the data has stopped coming, that is why it is 00000 flat 0, or it is 111 flat 1, until another 1 comes after 0. So at this point only it will get to know, okay, the data is coming. So if I rearrange my data in this format, it will continuously keep on repeating and it will continuously changing from high to low voltage, and the receiver would get to know, okay, data is coming. So this is how I'll extract the timing information by scrambling. So now coming to the basic part, which is the transmitter or scrambler. So this diagram represents the transmitter or the scrambler. So S was my signal and T is the rearranged transmitted signal. So S is the original signal. So S is going to T, and D1, D2, D3, D4, D5 are my shift registers. So here I made a distinction between D3 and D4. So you can make any transmitter circuit, or you can arrange and shift register in any of the format you require, but the only condition is that the receiver should also be having the same combination. So the first thing is, it is working on less number of bits. So it is having 5 shift registers, so it is working on less number of bits. So first thing is, if you want it to work on larger number of bits, you can have more number of shift registers and you can combine it in any possible format. So now this plus represents my modulo 2 addition. So what is the logic behind modulo 2 addition? So the logic is that if I have two similar bit, when I add it, it will give me 0. So if I add two different bits, it will give me 1. So these are two different bits, when I add it, it will give me 1. 0 plus 0, these are two same bits, it will give me 0. So this is how my modulo 2 addition works like, and this plus and this plus represents my modulo 2 addition. So the transmitted sequence is T is equal to, so first thing which is going to T is S after that. So here I'll get the T, T is multiplied to D1, D2, D3. So when T is multiplied to D3, so here T into D3 goes to the modulo 2 addition and then it goes to the S. So S plus D3 into T plus, now here D5 T goes to the modulo 2 addition. So from here T, here D5. So D5 into T modulo 2 addition, modulo 2 addition to S. So this is my transmitted sequence. So here also I have T and here also I have T. Now I have to simplify it. So I'll add D3T plus D5T to LHS and RHS. So what I saw, D3T plus D3T would be 0. D5T plus D5T would be 0. So here I am left only with S and here T plus D3T. So when I took T common, so now I'll take D3 plus D5 as F. So S is equal to T1 plus F. Now coming to the receiver or D scrambler. So this is my D scrambler circuit for this scrambler circuit. So here again I have 3 shift registers and 2 shift registers combined. So D1, D2, D3, D4, D5. So this is my transmitted sequence which is received. So this is my receiver, received sequence. So which is decoded by this D scrambler, and R is equal to the S. So R should be equal to S. So this D scrambler should work properly if received sequence is equal to S. So let's see how it is working. So R is equal to, so here from here I am getting T modulo 2 addition. So from here I am getting D3 into T. So T is going from here and D3T is modulo 2 added. After that D5T. So from here modulo 2 addition of D5T is happening. So here I have only T part in common. So I'll take T common. So here I represented D3 plus D5 as F. So I'll again replace D3 plus D5 as F. So R is equal to T multiplied by 1 plus F. S was also T multiplied by 1 plus F. So now let's take an example. So we are taking the same example. So we'll reduce the bits. It is actually a longer bit, so I'll not take a longer bit. So I took 8 bit data. So if I have to send it through the scrambler, so I have to find out the transmitted sequence. So in the transmitted sequence, initially when I have this circuit, so this is my transmitter circuit. So initially when I don't have any feedback, so first data which is going is S. So T is equal to S. So when I first applied the first feedback, so at that time T D3 plus T D5 is also going. So from here D3 and here D5. So D3 plus D5 is also going, which is F. So second, at the second feedback I have FS. At the third feedback again I'll multiply by F, so F square S. At the fourth feedback again I'll multiply by F, so F was my D3 plus D5. Now I have to find out F square. So when D3 plus D5 is multiplied by D3 plus D5, I'll get D6 plus D10 plus D8 plus D8. But D8 plus D8 D8 plus D8 would be 0. Because in modulo 2 addition, if I add two same bits, it would be 0. So I am left with D6 plus D10. So F square is equal to D6 plus D10. Now coming to the next part, which is F cube. F cube is equal to, how can I represent it? F square into F. So F square was D6 plus D10 when multiplied by D3 plus D5. So here I cannot cancel any term. So now the total T is S plus first delay plus second delay plus third delay. So now my data was of 8 bit length. So I only require delay up to 6. 9th delay is not required. Similarly, 10th, 11th, 13th and 15th delay are not required. So I need to find out all these values and then I have to add these values. So first I'll start from S. My S was, after that I have to provide 3 bit delay and then I have to provide S. So 3 bit delay means 30. After that I'll provide S. After that I'll provide 5 bit delay and 6 bit delay. So now the output would be the summation of these. So here 0, all zeros are added, it gave me 0, again 0, 0, here I got 1 1 1 0 0. So this is how my rearranged data looks like. So I'll stop my discussion here. I hope you like this video. If you like this, share it with your friends and send me some feedback. Thank you.